In the last session, we had learned about Kanauj and the famous ruler of Kanauj, Harshavardhan. Today, we are going to learn about Nalanda University, the life of the people during the Harsha's reign, and the Chinese traveler Huangshan, who visited India during Harsha's period. Firstly, we are going to learn about Nalanda University. Nalanda University is located in Bihar. The term Nalanda means giver of knowledge. Nalanda University was founded by the Gupta king Kumaragupta I. However, during the reign of Harsha, that it became the greatest center of Buddhist learning. Harsha patronized Nalanda University. It attained international reputation during his time. Grand and prosperous library of Nalanda University was known as Dharmaganj. Harsha donated 100 villages for its maintenance so that the institute could provide free education, boarding and food to teachers and students. Acharya Shilabhadra, who was a Buddhist monk and philosopher, made Nalanda into world famous university. Acharya Nagarjuna, who was a famous alchemist of Nalanda University, who proved that iron, arsenic and mercury ash could be used as medicine. Arsenic is often used as homeopathic remedies that are used for digestive disorders, allergies, etc. Students has to clear an entrance test for admission into Nalanda University. It was destroyed by the Muslim army led by Turkish leader Bakhtiar Khilji in 1193. Now we are going to learn about the life of people during Harsha's period. Information about the reign of King Harsha is available from the writings of Chinese traveler Huangshan. We'll learn about Huangshan in the next slide. Towns and villages of that time were fortified, and he had built huge gateways at their entrance. The society was divided into four groups. That is, during his period, the society was divided into Brahmins, Kshatriyas, Vaishyas, and Shudras. While the Parda system and intercaste marriages were not prevalent during Harsha's period. Parda system is a social and religious practice prevalent among some Muslim and Hindu communities in which women cover their bodies. Intercaste marriage. It is a marriage where two people from different caste marry each other. The position of women were not satisfactory during Harsha's period. Remarriage of widow was not permitted. Dowry system was commonly practiced during his period and started other social evil practices such as sati, child marriage and polygamy. Sati is a widow threw herself onto her husband's funeral pyre. Child marriage is defined as a marriage of a girl or boy before the age of 18. Polygamy is a custom that when a man is married to more than one wife at a time. The local diet or food during his period was milk and milk products, wheat, rice, fruits and vegetables. Dress. Men wore dhotis and women wore saris. They wore clean, simple white clothes. And about the ornaments. Their ornaments like rings, bangles, bracelets, necklaces were made from flowers. The popular means of entertainment were chess and games of dice. Acrobats or rope walker and conjurers or magician wandered from village to village entertaining the people. The main occupation of the people are farming and animal husbandry. Land revenue was 1/6 of the production. Internal and international trade was carried out by the Vaishyas. And he built the highway from Pataliputra to Bhrigu Kutch, that is Bharuch port, by the state for trade and transportation of goods. Gold and silver coins were used as currency for trade and exchange. Ornaments, statues, ivory and carved wooden pieces were exported, and the export of different materials from India increased her prosperity. During the reign of King Harsha, India had good business relations with Rome, which led to the inflow of gold in India. During his period, people followed Hinduism, Buddhism, and Jainism, and the people were tolerated towards other religions also. Next, we are going to learn about Huan Sang. The Chinese traveler Huan Sang visited India during Harsha's reign and studied Buddhism at Nalanda for 5 years. He wrote detailed description of India during the reign of Harsha in his book CUK. Huan Sang stayed in India for 15 years and visited different places. He was described the social, political, and religious conditions of that time. In 1645 CE, he returned to China via Central Asia and took with him many books, relics, and statues. During his stay, he attended the 6th Buddhist religious congregation at Prayag. There were 100 Buddhist mutts in Harsha's kingdom. Mutt means ashram. People lived a simple, pious and peaceful life. Cheating and a breach of promise were considered sinful during his period. Next, Huan Sang's travel route to India. Huan Sang came to India from China through Gandhar and visited many places like Takshila, Kashmir, Mathura, Haridwar, Kannauj, Pratama, Vaishali, Pataliputra, Gaya, Mahanadi, Kalinga, Danyakata, Sopara, Ujjain, and Gurjar. Here ends the part 2. We will be continuing this lesson in our next session. Thank you.